Hello and welcome everyone. So now let's try to enhance our layouts. So in this video we are going to use HTML5 layout. Okay, here if you see we are using the section, name, article, footer, header. All these are HTML5 native HTML tags. So we are going to use them and we are going to put a styles. Okay, like if you just put now we have added index.css in the link. Okay. Here in the head tag we can link the CSS. Link style sheet, and in href we can just say okay I have index.css, and in the index.css what we will do is our basic styles you start adding. Okay, now you can see the layout header. Header we are customizing using this. We are not putting dot header because it's not a class, it's a HTML tag. After header we have a section. Inside section we have a new tag, HTML5 tag, and article tag. So we'll just try to customize it and we will put them in the left and right alignment. Okay, so we have a new tag and we have article tag. So first of all, the new tag customization, what we can do is we can use a CSS float property. Just you will learn it later, I think, when I talk about the styling. But this is the new where you can add a float property, float left, width. So first new, this links are covering the left hand side, and then we have a content which will cover the right hand side. And what we can do is we just don't want these dots in the new link. So you can see new ul is a tag, so we can just say the list style type is none. So I think it will remove these dots, and padding and margin is zero. You can put margin top something. Okay, so this is a new tag. Now we have article tag which you wanted to put in the right hand side of it. Drag it a little bit. So I have a new links. Now I want articles also. So articles is like if the new tag is taking 30% width, then article will take 70% of it, right? And so we have to clear the float once we are done. So we have articles, we have this float property. So if we just try to increase it, now we will face some problem with the float property because we have to fix it. So in this HTML what we have is we have article, and inside article we have h1 paragraph tag, that's it, and we have a new tag, so that is coming in the section tag. So what we need to take care is inside this section we are giving 30% to the new and 70% to the article. So first of all, the alignment of both should be in the left because we are just using float left for the new tag. So we are creating two column boxes that float next to each other. So the float alignment is left and they will be adjacent to each other. So we have a new tag and we have a float property. Now what we can do is we can also customize a little bit on the footer side. And you will try to see how it looks like. So we have a footer. Footer can be customized in the same way. I will just try to put the whole. So here, the only difference which you see is what we have added is we have just added only the footer class. Footer is also having some background padding and all. And this is just to add the responsiveness in our application that, okay, if you are just increasing the size, then if you are just decreasing the size to 600 pixels, then I will just try to give a full height, full width to this new bar and this article section, because we need to maintain the responsiveness. I can't align them left and right, so I put 100% width. If you are good enough in the width, then I will just put a 30% to 60%, 3:7 ratio for the both the content. Okay, so if you just go to the styles, now we are using the native HTML5 tags header. You can just decrease the padding because we don't need that much. And the new bar, which is a float left with 30%. If you just want to decrease it to 20%, that is also fine. Here we can increase it to 80%. So this is the float property. Here you can see we just need a links here, and then rest of the 80% is going to article. Article is a native tag. Here we put a float left. So both are float left adjacent to each other. Then padding, and after section. Now you just see this. So after section I have to clear this float, so section colon after. So I have to clear the float. After once this section is over, I need to just display table and clear both property. This is required when you use the float. I mean, in the latest and modern styling, there are different ways. You can use a flexbox, you can use a discrete table, all these things to align the content in the left and right. You can use a grid column classes. But here we are at the beginner level and we are using the CSS float property to float the content to the left. So first of all, we have a nav ul li. So this is the style, list style we are not using, it's a none. And this also you will understand the box sizing, it's a content box and bordered box. I mean, bordered box means it will, the width of the border will be covered inside the width of a DOM node, width of a box. And just a simple, you can say height and width of this 100 pixel. Some global styling we can add. Padding 0 pixel. Because body is not having any margin padding. You're not having any margin padding. Now, so this is a very basic example we have done. Now, instead of putting London here, some article data about London, you can just put anything. And this can be your first simple HTML website for you, which has a header, footer, navbar and all, right? Thanks everyone.